just like I need you. Hold me, love me. Hold me, love me. I ain't got nothing.
Welcome to this week's edition of our Draft Utopia NFL Digest Week 15 highlights. Let's get straight into the 16 games for Week 15 so we can sort things out with 2 weeks to go. Chargers, Broncos, Keenan Allen got two receiving touchdowns on two receptions. Chargers win 27-20. Washington Redskins face the Atlanta Falcons. Kirk Cousins' NFL starting debut after backup games where he was RG3's backup. And things got rocky for the Redskins. Steven Jackson opened this game on a rushing touchdown where he trucked cornerback Josh Wilson. Tony Gonzalez got a receiving touchdown. The Falcons led 14-0. And Fred Davis caught a 23-yard pass from Kirk Cousins. Falcons led 14-7. Second quarter, Matt Bryant with a field goal, 17-7 Falcons. Kirk Cousins threw a 53-yard pass to Pierre Garçon, 17-14. Kai Forbath kicks back-to-back field goals. That puts the Redskins up 20-17 at halftime. Third quarter, Steven Jackson, 2-yard rushing touchdown. Falcons led 24-20. Atlanta up 27-20. Kirk Cousins threw a passing touchdown in the fourth quarter. Washington goes for the two-point conversion, hoping to win the game. It is no good. Atlanta wins 27-26. And it seems like the Washington Redskins lost this game more than Atlanta won it. If you look at the individual player statistics, Cousins had a 300-yard passing game. The Redskins lost 5 fumbles, 9 penalties by the Washington Redskins, 2 picks. There was a two-point conversion at the end. That's 5 reasons why the Falcons beat the Washington Redskins, and you have to be subjective towards the Redskins losing rather than objective towards the Falcons winning, because Atlanta took care of business early in this contest, especially with the Steven Jackson run where he trucked Josh Wilson. And you just look at everything that went against Washington in this contest. They have to play better against Dallas next week. And if the Cowboys lose to 3 consecutive backups, well, we know what's going to happen. But we'll get to that on Wednesday's podcast. Chicago Bears versus the Cleveland Browns. Billy Cundiff was the only player to score a field goal in the first quarter. Second quarter, Robbie Gould with a field goal. Cutler threw a pick six before making up for it with a Brandon Marshall touchdown. Zachary Bowman pick six. Browns tied it at 17. Bears tied it at 24. And Earl Bennett, a 4-yard pass from Jay Cutler. Michael Bush, 40-yard run. Bears led 38-24 and won 38-31. Chicago won this game with coverage. Jason Campbell got outstanding pass protection by the Cleveland Browns offensive line and failed to throw a passing touchdown. Great job by the Bears blanketing Cleveland's receivers. The cornerback play by Tim Jennings and Zachary Bowman was most impressive. And turnovers by Cleveland and defensive play at times helped the Browns keep it close. But you knew Chicago was going to get this win from the start. Texans-Colts. Andrew Luck opened this game with a passing touchdown to Griff Whalen. Colts led 7-0 before Reggie Bullock scored on a field goal. Jonathan Joseph picked off Andrew Luck on a throw. Vinatieri kicked a field goal, made it 10-3. There was a shovel pitch from Andrew Luck to Trent Richardson. That made it 17-3. Colts led 20-3 at halftime and won this game 25-3 with their final score coming off a safety. Brooks Reed got by Goster Chereles at times in this contest, humiliating Colts right tackle. The Colts were phenomenal, taking care of business against the Texans. Indianapolis secures the AFC South. Buffalo Bills versus the Jacksonville Jaguars. Both teams took turns scoring field goals in the first quarter. And since I already told you the Colts locked up the division, this game practically has no implications. Mercedes Lewis had a passing touchdown caught from Chad Henne to Mercedes Lewis. Emmanuel had a critical passing touchdown at the end. The Bills won this contest 27-20, and this game kept going back and forth. I said the team with the middle linebacker that recorded the most tackles would win. Paul Posluszny had more tackles at middle linebacker for the Jaguars and rookie Kiko Alonso, who's been phenomenal this year. 3 touchdowns by E.J. Manuel, 2 passing, 1 rushing touchdown, less turnovers as Manuel wins a turnover battle over Chad Henne. New England Patriots versus the Miami Dolphins. Patriots took a 10-0 lead before the Dolphins came back and put up 17 unanswered points. Patriots scored another 10 points. Poor coverage by Dont'a Hightower, struggling to play zone coverage. Michael Thomas with a critical deflection to prevent a Patriots touchdown. It looked like Danny Amendola had the game-winning reception on first down. Then there's the late-game interception by safety Michael Thomas. Those two attributes led to the Miami Dolphins upsetting the New England Patriots. Philadelphia Eagles versus the Minnesota Vikings. Greg Jennings caught a 57-yard pass from Matt Castle in the first quarter. Castle began the game 7-for-7. Jennings finished with 11 receptions, 163 receiving yards, and one receiving touchdown. Blair Walsh kicked a field goal in the second quarter, and the Vikings went ahead 10-3 at that point. Eagles got two more field goals, but trailed 17-9 at halftime. Third quarter, Matt Castle, 6-yard rushing touchdown, 24-9 Vikings. Blair Walsh with a field goal. Vikings led 27-9 at one point. Later in the third, Nick Foles threw a 30-yard pass to DeSean Jackson. Jackson finished the contest with 10 receptions, 195 receiving yards, and one receiving touchdown. Hurts caught a 3-yard pass from Foles, but failed the 2-point conversion. Vikings led 27-22 after three. Matt Iaista, the third-string running back, with a rushing touchdown. He got three rushing touchdowns, but was held to 50-some rushing yards. Vikings won this contest 48-30. Vikings exploited a lousy secondary. They kept LeSean McCoy to 8 carries for 35 yards on the ground. Jared Allen, Brian Robeson, both with 2 sacks. Vikings played like the better team in this contest, and this was one of those games where Matt Khalil pass protects when the defensive line gets pressure on the quarterback. When Greg Jennings has 100 yards, they're going to win regardless of who's playing quarterback, and they win with style. They win with swagger, and that's what we saw from the Minnesota Vikings this week. Seattle Seahawks versus the New York Giants. Seahawks won 23-0. Eli Manning, 18-for-31, 156 passing yards, 0 passing touchdowns, and 5 picks. Curtis Painter went 4-for-4 as a backup. The Giants were that mediocre today because there were times where this Giants defense got some pressure on Russell Wilson, and the running game didn't have a 100-yard rusher, but the run blocking was phenomenal. Russell Wilson was able to get off on his throws without reacting to pressure. 49ers versus Buccaneers. First quarter, Colin Kaepernick faces intense pressure. Michael Crabtree with a 4-yard receiving touchdown from Colin Kaepernick. Second quarter, Phil Dawson hit a 47-yard field goal, 10-0 Niners. Vernon Davis with a 52-yard passing touchdown from Colin Kaepernick. Kaepernick throws the passing touchdown to Vernon Davis, who would get a receiving touchdown at tight end. Niners won that contest 33-14. And on defense, you saw guys like Alden Smith, Patrick Willis, Justin Smith get to the quarterback, get that pressure on Mike Glennon. And the 49ers defense is getting hot at the right time. I think you have to factor that into account with the way this team is playing right now. And we saw the run blocking by the Niners. I think the 49ers are the hottest team in the NFC right now, despite Seattle's win on Sunday earlier against the Giants. I know Russell Wilson's undefeated at home in his career, but the Niners have the linebackers projecting the right body language right now. They've got guys getting pressure on the quarterback, and the Niners are not a team I want to face if I'm heading into the postseason, because they're last year's NFC champions, and they got to the NFC title in Jim Harbaugh's first year as head coach. New York Jets versus Carolina Panthers. Both teams exchanged field goals early in the first and early in the second. Panthers won 30-20. Cam Newton, 16-for-24, 273 passing yards, 1 passing touchdown, and no picks. Chiefs-Raiders. Chiefs blow out the Raiders 56-31. Alex Smith, 5 passing touchdowns. Jamal Charles, 1 rushing touchdown, 4 receiving touchdowns through the air. Charles with a huge day in fantasy football. Huge day for the Chiefs as they get a blowout win. Brandon Albert fully healthy, and that led to a blowout. Charles, 51 fantasy points overall. Simply disgusting day for the Chiefs. Green Bay Packers versus Dallas Cowboys. Cowboys led 26-3 at halftime. Packers came back to gain a 37-36 lead with Eddie Lacy getting a rushing touchdown. Tony Romo threw 2 late-game interceptions in the fourth quarter, one to Sam Shields and the other one was to Tremone Williams. Simply unacceptable. Romo loses to backup quarterbacks in back-to-back weeks with Josh McCown and Matt Flynn, and he gets a third backup in Kirk Cousins, who looked phenomenal, and he might have beaten the Atlanta Falcons if it wasn't for so many penalties, if it wasn't for the fumbles. So you look at both the Redskins and the Cowboys, two teams with arguably the worst secondaries in the NFL, and it's going to be interesting to see how that game folds, because I think the Redskins are capable of winning at home with Kirk Cousins starting, if he plays well again. And Romo could lose to 3 consecutive backups, which at that point, you've got to pull the plug on Tony Romo. It's a must-win for Romo next week. Saints versus Rams. Rams led 27-3 after three quarters before the Saints scored a touchdown. Rams' offensive line was flawless. Pass blocking, run blocking, zone blocking. Kellen Clemens, two touchdowns, no picks. Zach Stacy, 28 carries, 133 rushing yards, and one rushing touchdown. Breeze didn't throw a passing touchdown until late in the fourth quarter. Great job by the Rams coming together to win as a team against the New Orleans Saints with guys like Robert Quinn and Chris Long getting pressure on the quarterback. The Rams' secondary covering. Cardinals versus Titans. Ryan Fitzpatrick, 402 passing yards, four touchdowns, two picks, caused this game to go into overtime. In the end, you knew the Cardinals would win. That's exactly what they did. And even though the Cardinals are winning right now, they're on the outside of the playoff picture looking in because you're getting competition from the 49ers and you're getting competition from a lot of these other teams in the NFC. Bengals versus Steelers. Le'Veon Bell obtains a rushing touchdown after the Bengals fumble on a punt early in the game. Antonio Brown caught a 12-yard touchdown pass from Ben Roethlisberger because Roethlisberger received 7 seconds in the pocket to make a throw. Antonio Brown's 67-yard punt return from Ben Roethlisberger. Remarkable offense, defense, and special teams led to a critical Steelers win, even though the odds of them making the playoffs are minimal. Ravens-Lions. First quarter, Reggie Bush got a rushing touchdown. 7-0 Lions after one. Ravens got four consecutive field goals by Jason Tucker before the Lions got a field goal. Ravens led 12-10 after three quarters. Fourth quarter, Ravens kick a field goal. Jason Tucker, 15-10. Ravens at that point. Matthew Stafford gets the ball to Joseph Fourier for a passing touchdown through the air. Receiving touchdown by Fourier. Touchdown Lions. Lions go for a two-point conversion and fail. 16-15, 43 seconds. Jason Tucker with a sixth field goal. Ravens take the lead 18-16 with 38 seconds left. He hits the bottom right corner, and the field goal goes in. Jason Tucker gets those 3 points for the Ravens, and Matthew Stafford gets the ball back. He threw a pick to Matt Elam with 30 seconds left. Ray Rice rushes for a first down. Ravens win 18-16. Excellent defensive contest. Stafford's three picks. Both defenses did well, but the leg of Jason Tucker prevailed as the Ravens go to 8-6. The Ravens just continue to get hot at the right time, and that matters because this team has Dennis Pitta back at tight end in addition to Ed Dixon. You got your running backs back. You've got two offensive tackles, and as long as the secondary plays like they did tonight against the Lions, the Baltimore Ravens have a chance to go to the AFC title game, assuming they don't draw the Denver Broncos in the divisional round. But it's going to be really interesting to see how that pans out. And I think the Ravens are capable of beating the Bengals or the Indianapolis Colts in the wild card game, the way they're playing right now in terms of momentum. That's it for this week's edition. Next week, I will be in Las Vegas. I don't know if I'll be doing a video yet, but I'll try to get something up. And I'm going to do my podcast for Draft Utopia on Thursday after I go see the new Anchorman movie. I might move it up to Wednesday night, but I'm thinking Thursday afternoon or Thursday morning at this point. But we'll see what happens. Thanks for listening to our Week 15 highlights. Enjoy your NFL recap.